this woman to be married to this man.
I happily do.
Spencer, do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife, according to God's ordinance, in the holy state of matrimony? Do you promise from this day forward to provide for her spiritual leadership? Do you promise to love her and comfort her, nourish her and cherish her, and forsaking all others, remain faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
Thank you.
Kaylee, do you take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband, according to God's ordinance, in this holy state of matrimony? Do you promise from this day forward to follow him as your spiritual leader? Do you promise to love him and encourage him, respect and honor him, and forsaking all others, remaining faithful to him so long as you both shall live? And the Lord God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Marriage is the completion of God's creation. So when we look at the creation account in the book of Genesis, we see that marriage really is the completion of God's creations. That means that you, Spencer, and you, Kaylee, in the truest sense, complete each other. You are now a complete creation. God has made you one in him. Kaylee, please face Spencer. Hold his hands up, palms up, so you see the gift that they are. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and vibrant, with love that are holding yours on your wedding day as he promises to love you all the days of his life. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future, as you laugh and cry, as you share your innermost secrets and dreams. These are the hands that look so large and strong, yet will be gentle as he holds your baby for the first time. These are the hands that will work long hours for you and your new family. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will countless times wipe away your tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, tears of joy. These are the hands that will comfort you in illness and hold you when fear and grief rack your mind. These are the hands that will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into his eyes, eyes that are filled completely with overwhelming love and desire for you. Spencer, please hold Kaylee's hands, palms up. Where you can see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, smooth, young, and carefree, that are holding yours on your wedding day as she pledges her love and commitment to you all the days of her life. These are the hands that will hold each child in tender love, soothing them through illness and hurt, supporting and encouraging them along the way, and knowing when it's time to let go. These are the hands that will massage the tension from your neck and back in the evenings after you've both had a long day. These are the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times. These are the hands that will comfort you when you are sick or console you when you are grieving. These are the hands that will passionately love and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will give you support as she encourages you to chase down your dreams. Together as a team, everything you wish can be realized. Let us pray. God bless these hands that you see before you this day. May they always be held by one another. God give them strength to hold on during the storms of stress and dark of disillusionment. Keep them tender and gentle as they nurture each other in their wondrous love, and help these hands to continue building a relationship founded on your grace, rich in caring, devoted in reaching for your perfection. May Spencer and Kaylee see these four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. We ask this in your name. Amen. Spencer? Please repeat after me. I, Spencer, take you, Kaylee, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, from this day forward. Kaylee, please repeat after me. I, Kaylee, take you, Spencer, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, from this day forward and forever. As you both wear these rings, I'd like you to remember that they symbolize two things. The rings are made of precious metals, and as precious metals are refined by fire, so too the heat of trials in your life will not destroy, but will only serve to refine your love for each other. These rings are neither beginning nor end. In the same way, Jesus had neither beginning nor end. Therefore, as you wear these rings, let them remind you that Jesus is always with you. He'll never leave you or forsake you. He will always be there for you and help you be the husband and be the wife that he has intended you to be. Spencer? Place the ring on Kaylee's finger and repeat after me. You are my life.
You are my life.
My love. My best friend. With this ring, I do wed. May it be a reminder of the true love and the sacred commitment I have made here today. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I just want to, well, we would like to thank everyone for coming today. You guys are really important to us, and we can't wait to share our journey with you, and it's been really exciting so far, and I want to thank everyone for the part in our lives that you all have had.
Okay, so continue here. I am Kaylee's little sister and biggest, I guess. So, Kaylee, you look completely gorgeous. And I don't know if you saw, but I was like teared up because this is big. And Spencer, you don't look half bad yourself there. So, throughout our childhood, we laughed, we cried, we played, we created memories that I will never forget. And throughout all that time, Kaylee has been one of the most inspirational people to me. Her strength is incredible. Her ability to set her mind to something and complete that is amazing. And I am so excited to see what the future holds for them. And I can't wait to be a part of that, including, you know, my little nephews and nieces. But anyways, to their future.
Hello, I'm the best man for Spencer, Justin. And I just want to say ditto to Susan. Also, I'd like to thank the Joneses family for putting everything together today. And I just have to say to Kaylee and Spencer that since I'm up here doing this, and this is one of the worst things for me, I really must love you. So I actually read something. I wanted to thank all of you guys for coming today and sharing this special occasion with all of us, and with Kaylee and Spencer. I've known Spencer since first day he was born, and we were pretty much friends straight off the bat, except for probably the first 5 minutes he came into my room. I was really happy when Spencer met Kaylee and they started dating. Ever since then, they've been pretty much inseparable. You normally don't see either of them without the other. And I think that's something that's really important. I hope you guys have a wonderful journey with each other. And here's to you two.
I want to say big congratulations to Spencer and Kaylee. It seems like it was just a night not too long ago that Spencer and the boys were going out to see a movie up at the Jones house. And I thought, okay. And then we started seeing them a lot more, and beautiful friendship came out of that and progressed to dating, and here we are today. So I'm so proud of both of you, and we wish you the best, and we're going to be praying for the best for both of you, and look forward to everything to come as you guys make your life and write your story that you're going to progress through life. So, wish you the best. I love my Here's Spencer and Kaylee.
Spencer. You have already made my firstborn happy. These two are two peas in a pod. Be adventurous, learn, love, have thrill in life. Break out of your comfort zone together. You'll be stronger together than you ever have been apart. Here's to Spencer.
Come closer, you're says it's all up to you. Nicely done. Like the rig toss. Are you ready? I'm going to start it. Can you folks bring it down for me? Here we go. Five.
Four. Three. Two. One.
All right. We got a winner. Ladies and gentlemen, nice big round of applause for our bride and groom as they complete their first dance together as husband and wife.